Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. Today's video is about moving states and my experience last year moving from Georgia to Louisiana and just the tips that I want to include to help make your moving experience as smooth as possible. Also, I want to include some tips that I have since read online that I find really important that I didn't include in my moving experience. So let's just jump right into it. So for a little bit of background, I never moved in my entire life before moving here. I never moved more than 30 minutes away. I was born in Macon, Georgia, which is the very center of the state. Both of my parents were born there, and we have a lot of ties and family history in Georgia. So we never really moved around, even though my dad owns a personal company and he can do everything from his computer, and my mom doesn't work. So we literally lived in the same place all of my life and for their entire lives as well. And yet, we did travel a lot. I also worked for modeling, so I'm really good at packing a suitcase for a couple of months, but I never really picked up my life in one location and moved it to a completely different area until last year. And that's kind of what I want to talk about today. Obviously, you're physically moving somewhere, but there are emotional and like mental strains that you can also face during this period of time. Moving is stressful. Moving is a large part of your life when you're going somewhere for a job or you're moving to be with a partner, which was my case, or you're moving to leave behind an old place that no longer serves you, or you find a purpose in a new location. So that's kind of what I want to cover today. To give you guys a little bit of background, I was born in Georgia, like I said. My parents and I moved to Warner Robins, Georgia, which is an Air Force town. I'm not really sure why we moved there when I was 2 years old, but we stayed in that house until I was 15 years old. And then when we moved to a very small town just south of Warner Robins, Georgia, it's called Kathleen, I was 15, and I lived in that house until I left when I was 18. And I left my house unconventionally. My dad and I were butting heads. My mom and I weren't getting along. So I lived with a friend and her parents at their house that was 5 minutes away from my parents. But that was a difficult time because I had not graduated high school yet. I hadn't begun college. And I still had a lot of my personal belongings at my parents' house, but just enough clothes, my toothbrush, my books for school to get by in high school. So that was a difficult, very unconventional, unique situation that I was in. But eventually when I graduated high school and I was going to my first semester at college, I went home, I packed up everything, and I moved to Atlanta. And I lived in Georgia State University's dorms for a year and a half. And after that year and a half, I and a friend got an apartment in Atlanta. Actually, it was Decatur, which is East Atlanta. And that was such a milestone for me. Like I said, I had modeled in other countries before and I had packed up my suitcase and been gone for like 3 months on end. But it's different than moving and creating a place for yourself that you know you'll get to call home for at least a year. And that's what I did. I signed a lease in Atlanta for a year, and I was actually taking my gap year during that time. My friend and my roommate, he was going to school, and I was working full time. And we were really just living young adult lives and learning the responsibilities that come with living on your own for the first time outside of a dorm and outside of an institutionalized, you know, area where other people are going through similar situations. I mean, some of our neighbors at this apartment complex were really nice, came from a decent family, and then some other neighbors were like crackheads with dogs that they bred inside of their apartment. So yeah, it was a really good experience. Needless to say, it was fun and exciting, and also stressful at times, paying your own rent. And after living at that apartment for a year, my boyfriend and I were coming up on 3 years of dating, and so he extended the invitation for me to move to Louisiana. We have a house here in Shreveport now, and we're actually about to build our own house. And of course, everybody, like my friends, was for this decision. As long as I was happy, they were happy, but my parents were totally not for it. My parents and I still don't get along to this day, but I made the decision to move because I felt it was what's best for me. And I'm so glad I trusted my heart, and I'm so glad that I listened to my intuition, because it really has been the best decision I've made for myself, I would say, as a young adult. So, enough about my history. I'll go ahead and jump into the tips and my recommendations to help you move as best as possible. Okay guys, so for my first tip of making an easy transition to where you're going is having a job lined up. So maybe you're in the same boat as me, maybe you're still in college, but you are financially independent of your parents, you need a source of income. I was moving here to be with my boyfriend and his family in Louisiana, and I moved there on the whim, hoping that a job would fall into my lap. And I don't mean I moved here just without thinking about it. I had definitely meditated on coming here and why I wanted to be here with my boyfriend and his family. But I moved here on a whim as far as my job being concerned. I was not really modeling in Atlanta. I was actually a swim instructor for children ages 3 months all the way to 12 years old. And that was a good job. It was also a really good job because I was around other college students and I enjoyed that work environment. But moving from Atlanta to a much smaller city like Shreveport, I knew that I would be limited as far as job options. There is a place here that offers those swim lessons that I definitely could have done, and I definitely could have started serving or, you know, doing something like that. But I really wanted to submit my resume, submit what I have already done in the past to many locations here in Shreveport and see who got back with me. And I was actually out of a job here for 3 months until I started working. And that was a really big impact on my savings. That definitely had me nervous for a while, and I don't like to rely on others for money. So it was difficult for me to budget and also be comfortable here at the same time because I moved here without a job lined up. So that is my first tip. Please have a job lined up. Maybe you're moving because of a job, but maybe you're like me and we're moving to be with someone and to close that long distance gap. That is really important because financial problems can cause, you know, strife and cause stress between like the two of you. And even though Taylor, my boyfriend, has a really stable job, good money and everything, and he definitely supported me, I just didn't like to be supported coming from, you know, my personal background where I feel like money can cause like a lot of corruption and it causes a lot of problems. I won't go into it, but I definitely came from that background and I saw how money can divide people. So having said that, just have a job lined up wherever you're going. I also want to quickly mention that I'm working for a jewelry store here and I love it, and I'm so glad that I held out for the perfect job that I love, because trust me, there's nothing like waking up and going to a job that you don't like having. So yeah, there's one thing for like waiting until like a better opportunity comes, but then there's also like not having a job at all and like no one really reaching out to you. So just wanted to mention that. Okay, my number two tip is actually the moving process. There's a lot of Pinterest boards online and checklists made for how to move economically on a budget, especially when you're moving multiple states away. I was moving from Georgia to Louisiana, which is a 9-hour drive, and thankfully, I had one of my closest friends come before the move, help me declutter, help me get rid of things, clothes, furniture, items that were sentimental to me but I really didn't need in my life. She really helped me filter through my apartment and get rid of everything that didn't need to come with me. And that was really helpful if you have a family member or a friend who's willing to come help you wherever you're at. Throw away garbage, filter through things that you can donate or give away to somebody else who could better use them. That is a wonderful tool to have, because with all of your stuff, it's hard to have a third opinion, and it's hard to have a different set of eyes looking at something wondering, is this just gonna take up space? So that's really important, but also having friends to help you move is really important. Three of my other good friends came with me to Louisiana. One of them drove her car and another one of my friends rode with her, and then my other friend rode with me, and we packed up my car and her car, and everything of mine fit into two regular size cars, which is amazing. If you are around 20, 21, 22, chances are that you don't have that much stuff. I wasn't moving a washer and a dryer. I wasn't moving a large refrigerator. I really didn't have that much besides like my bed frame, my bed. My boyfriend came a couple of days prior to me moving and picked up my bed and put it in his truck and drove back to Louisiana. So I had a lot of third party help during my actual moving process. So it really cut out the need for a moving truck or a U-Haul trailer or anything like that. So I'm really grateful to my friends. Shout out to Adelaide, Kristen, Carter, and Camilla, because without you guys, I would have not gotten here safely, cheaply, also with like a lot of love and support around me during that drive. So thank you guys so much. All right, guys, my third tip is having your federal and state papers in check. Having a lot of your credit cards, debit cards, pieces of mail that you get to one address changed to another is really important, guys. I actually had my 2019 tax return sent to my Atlanta address this year, and I live all the way in Shreveport, Louisiana. So I had to call my old boss and say, hey, you know, I moved. Would you mind having that remailed to me? And she did, thankfully, but I know not all bosses are like that. So along with your license and along with your registration with your car, if you have a car, it's really important to get stuff changed over to the address that you will currently be living in. For instance, I was banking with Wells Fargo in Atlanta. Wells Fargo is an American bank where a lot of students will use Wells Fargo as like a savings account and checking and things like that. It's just like Bank of America or Chase. But here in Shreveport, Louisiana, there is no Wells Fargo. There would be no place for me to deposit or withdraw money. So I had to go ahead and research that before I moved and make that change with my banks and tell Wells Fargo goodbye. I'm moving to Louisiana because you guys don't have a branch there. And they understood. And then I applied and opened a checking account with Chase Bank, which I'm super happy with. But that's just a really good tip to have prior to actually moving, because then you won't even have to stress, oh, is that piece of mail going to my old address or my new address? And it's really a time saver, especially when tax season came this year. I was like, oh my gosh, there's a check with my name on it with, like, you know, a lot of money, well, not a lot of money, but a lot of money for me going to somebody else who lives in that apartment. So that's my third tip, and it's really important. Okay, guys, tip number four is kind of funny, but it makes a lot of sense. Tip number four is about supplies and what you're going to need to move. I had a lot of books and papers and pencils and pens and crafts coming with me, and I didn't have a large box to collect all of that stuff in and to make it easy to transport. So what I did is I went to Target, Walmart, Lowe's, and Home Depot before I moved. This was in Atlanta, Georgia, and I would go around nighttime, maybe like 9 or 10 p.m., and I would collect boxes to put stuff in. Also, my roommate worked at a home goods store and like a home and yard improvement like rental facility. So he had a lot of boxes on hand, and he also brought those back to the apartment for us to pack our things in, which made it super easy when we were actually transporting stuff. It's easy to throw a lot of stuff in a box and tape it so that nothing will come out and throw it in your car and be done with it. So I actually think I didn't collect enough boxes beforehand, and I had a lot of loose items in the car, and it made it kind of messy when we were loading and unloading the items. So that is an important tip that I think you could easily take care of before you actually move. Okay, guys, here's tip number five. This definitely falls into the mental and emotional aspect of moving. This tip is about realizing where you're going. If you're familiar with this area already, that's great. If you're not familiar with that area that you're moving to, I would recommend having your mind adjust to the weather that you're moving to. I moved literally just horizontally across the United States. I didn't go north and I didn't go south. Really, I just went parallel to where I already lived. So the weather really is the same, but as far as knowing where I was going for how long was important to me too. And what I mean by that is visualizing your space that you're about to have, making sure that you have furniture for that space, but not limiting yourself to making that place your home forever, if that makes sense. So I like to travel and I like to experience new places, but I like having a home to come back to, but I don't like feeling stuck there, if that makes sense. And I think that actually comes from my childhood. My parents are not people who would move far away for no reason or out of this sense of adventure. And there's a lot of people like that, but I'm not like that. And I always want to think about the next place I'm going. So this house that we're actually in now doesn't belong to us. It belongs to my boyfriend's sister. And she and my boyfriend's family are flipping it to resell. So in my mind, I said, okay, well, I love this space. I had been here before actually moving here. So I knew what I was coming into, pretty much. And I also knew that I would be leaving here one day. Like, this is not our final place. I know that I don't need to buy, you know, $5,000 worth of furniture to go in here because it's not going to last. Also, I'm not going to stay here. So in my opinion, visualizing where you're going is important. Understand how long you are going to be there. You know, and not everybody knows, people bounce around and things like that, but knowing and giving yourself an estimate is really important to me. Not feeling stuck, not feeling like you're obligated to buy things for the house or apartment that you're in. So I hope I've explained myself well for this tip. It is important to me, and it really helps me mentally move into this place and not feel like a foreigner or feel like I'm moving into a situation I don't know anything about. So yeah, those are my 5 major tips for moving. I hope that if you are in the process or you're about to move soon, these help you. If you have any moving tips that you have had personally, please let me know, because this is not our last move. This is not our home forever. So I would love some tips for how your move went and if you made it a better experience for yourself. Thank you guys so much for watching. I will be back with another video soon. And as always, love you guys. Mwah! And I'll see you guys later. Bye.